Interesting name. We'll see how this plays out.
Look out of there now! He wasn't alone! Repeat, evacuate position immediately! Get to the rendezvous point now!
Oh, so that's how it is.
He went that way!
Halo is inbound for evac!
Hurry,
your feet.
He's getting away!
You know, if I'm supposed to be a dedicated sniper and all I get is this rifle, it'd be nice if it was not a mediocre scout I've been using for the past several missions. I guess there's at least a USP, it has ammo this time. Still, it's quite a missed opportunity. Seems like every other mission, you get a scout and a shotgun. And look, there's the shotgun. You know, I think our control is the same voice actor who plays the German GSG-9. Smooth. I bet that guy will get a Darwin Award for that. Man, there are a lot of guys. You know, when I picture Tokyo, I imagine something a little safer. Few less gang members. Clearly, Japan's gun control has failed. Grab some handgun ammo, that's always useful. Now if you look closely, you can see that guy's got quite a few less polys than he should. It's because he's a low-res model, you can see them occasionally, and they're pretty funny when you do, because it's so incredibly obvious. It looks something out of the original Quake, rather than the normal enemies we face. Luckily, there's a Galil here to break up the monotony of the scout and USP, which is good, but it only comes in about halfway through the mission, which is really disappointing, I must say. Especially since, as far as I know, this is the only time we get to use the Galil. Whereas, I think just about every other mission we've gotten either a Galil or a pump shotgun.
Get away
I heard
from
something.
Me.
Ah, an elevator. That must have been it. Glass and no way around it. I think I know what happens here. And, yep. What a surprise. Now there's also an auto shotty, which is nice, but we're getting near to the end of the level, so it's really just too little too late. I think this game would have benefited immensely from a weapon select. Now, on a different note, you see that civilian walking up there? Whatever you do, don't shoot him. He's bulletproof, but if you shoot him, you'll fail the mission, saying that you ran out of time in a few moments. And the best part about that is that it breaks the level, so that when you restart, it automatically puts you at the end part where you only have a minute.
You only got another minute before they have to leave.
Well, that. So yeah, just don't shoot it. The levels in this are really easy to break.
Over here. The truck is over here.
You know, I think this had the potential to be a really good level.
Let's go.
But the player should have been given an option. Oh well.